This video is going to use the fx-300ESPlus2 scientific calculator to do absolute value calculations. So we're going to show you two different ways depending on the type of input that you're doing. So the first thing we do when we get into this calculator is go into our mode, and we want to be doing computations. So we're going to choose number one. And I'm going to first show you how you would do this with math input output. So I'm going to go to setup. So you'll see that next to mode is yellow setup. So I'm going to hit shift setup. And we have two options here. We have one for math input output or two for linear input output. So I'm going to show you how it looks in both because it is different. So let's go into number one. This is what you would do. What kind of result do you want? We want math. So we're going to do one. And now let's say we want to find the absolute value of a number. So let's just enter, say, negative 12. You'll see that the absolute value function button is right below shift, and it is ABS, that stands for absolute. So I'm going to click that. And now remember, I'm in math input output. So it's going to actually do the typical standard notation for absolute value, which is those two bars. And so inside, I'm going to enter the value or function that I'm trying to find the absolute value of. So we're going to say negative, forgot what I said. So we're just going to make up one, negative 45. And once I'm done, I can go outside of that. I could add things to it. I could just hit equals, and it's going to give me the absolute value of that input that I gave. So if we try a different one, we could even put absolute value of an expression. So let's do again, absolute value. And this time let's do 35 minus 94. And again, if I just hit execute, it's going to be the absolute value of that expression. I can also do absolute values of functions. So let's say I assign a value to x, and to do that, I want to use my store function. Let's give x a value of 5 right now. So I'm going to hit 5, store, so shift, recall, and I'm going to store it into my x value, which is right here. So notice that it shows me that 5 is now being stored as my x. And now let's do some absolute value calculations with x. So we're going to hit absolute value. We're going to put in our alpha x, I don't know, minus 8, and then times 2. What's the absolute value of that? So when you're in math input, the absolute value looks exactly as we would expect in standard notation with our little straight brackets here. Let's go back to setup. So shift, setup. And this time, let's do linear input or output. So that's number two, and I want to show you the difference. So the first one we did was a negative 45, absolute value of negative 45. I'm still going to hit the absolute value button, but I want you to see the difference. Instead of the standard notation, it's using the word absolute value, and it creates a parenthesis. So in the parentheses, I need to put in my value here, so negative 45, close my parentheses, and now hit equals. So the difference between linear input and math input output is that math input output is more standard notation, and this is using linear output. And so same thing, if I were to do that mathematical expression, we're going to hit absolute value, and we're going to hit our x, so alpha x minus, let's do 94, close the parentheses, and then I could do times 2 here. So the main difference is my absolute uses the word and parentheses versus the standard notation for absolute value.